Hello folks, Andrit here, welcome to this new video. Today we're going to do this in Clickteam Fusion. We're going to make this countdown. Like you can see, it uses some really nice effects. Under 10 seconds it becomes red and uses this fade out effect. Like always, I have just a basic platformer movement. And I have two counters, one for minutes, one for seconds. Being the Y, I can apply some RGB coefficients. So I have a clone of the seconds, and in this I apply the red coefficient. I have a string as well, and inside of this I've written time is over. And last but not least, we need three variables. I'm using global variables, since counters doesn't support variables on itself. I'm using a variable for minutes, a variable for seconds, and a variable for special effects. And we're going to apply the transparency. Remember, 0 is visible, 255 is transparent. Now let's jump to the event editor. Inside here I have a group of events already set for the platformer movement object. These are just basic mechanics. Now let's make the magic happen. The first thing, I'm going to add a star frame. So first thing, I'm going to set the seconds to the seconds. So I'm going to retrieve the value from the global value seconds. Then I'm going to set the minutes to the global value minutes. And now after that, I'm going to start a flashing on the two dots, just to give the look to a timer. And I'm going to set the flashing to half of a second. Last but not least, we need to make the time is over string invisible. Now let's start making the countdown. Here I'm going to check if the seconds are greater than 0, and then every second I'm going to subtract 1 from the counter seconds. After that, I'm going to make sure that if we have more than 1 minute available, we're going to subtract from this minute 1 each time the seconds are 0, and we're setting the seconds to 60. So basically, if seconds are 0 and minutes are greater than 0, subtract from minutes 1 and set the counter of seconds to 60. Now you probably remember that my red counter was outside the screen. Let's make the FX happen. If the value of seconds is different from the value of seconds to the red one, and if minutes are 0 and seconds itself are equal or lower than 0, I'm going to set the position of the seconds to the seconds. I'm going to set the value of seconds to the seconds. And last but not least, I'm going to set the global value FX to 0. Now let's jump to a new event and let's check that if the global value FX is lower than 255, I'm going to set the alpha blending coefficient of seconds 2 to the global value of FX, and then I'm going to add to the global value FX 10. Last but not least, we need to make visible the time is over string. So if seconds are 0 and minutes are 0, just go under string and make it reappear. Now let's check if it's working. Okay, it's working. You're done. Leave a like and subscribe!